That's you. This is your show. That music is from Nightmare Before Christmas.
We're in the fall holiday swing, and many of us have incorporated gourd, squash, and pumpkins into the kitchen and decor. And here to teach us the difference and the science of each is our very own Beetlejuice himself, Dan Kohler.
Ooh.
Oh. Hey, we are so impressed with you, mister.
Let's hear it.
Hey.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Exactly. What is Beetlejuice?
What is Beetlejuice?
Oh, I'm sorry. Oh. We're getting into the squishes and the gourdses.
Squishes and the gourdses.
Yeah,
the squishes and the gourdses. So squash are a native. Shirley must know this. I'm sure she's talked about it. Squash are actually fruit. They are not vegetables. And by the way, dig in. You've got a delicious ricotta tart with delicata squash.
Oh.
Pass it to the kids in the back.
Yeah.
Share. Sharing is caring.
No.
So squash are actually modified berries. They are not vegetables at all. They are berries, but they are some of the oldest cultivated fruits that are used as vegetables in this country. They've been grown here for about 9,000 years, which is kind of amazing to think of. And the reason they've been grown in this country for 9,000 years is precisely because of the nutrition that they offer us. So what's interesting about squash in general is that we think of them for the starchy sort of meaty quality, right? They can fill you up. They have a lot of nutrition there. They're sweet. They're fibrous. But what was interesting is that 9,000 years ago, the reason that native peoples were cultivating these was specifically for the seeds inside. Who likes roasted pumpkin seeds? Thank you. So roasted pumpkin seeds are really essential to growing cultures because they provide fat and protein in an otherwise barren landscape, right? Because they're very oily in there, and they're very healthy for cultures that are on the move. And the other fascinating thing about squash and gourds and things like this, they can keep for months. So once you've grown them, as long as you have a root cellar or something, they're very good for people who were traveling.
Shelf life.
Yeah, you have a huge shelf life. But let's really discuss the main point of contention here. What makes a squash, what makes a gourd, and what makes a pumpkin?
Exactly.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay. Bring it on. Now the truth is, they are all the same. There's actually a difference. We use the words differently. So what we call a squash is something that has a hard rind that you have to cut through, but also has enough meaty flesh that you can cook. What we would call a gourd, conversely, something that has a very tough rind.
Can you eat those?
Well, they don't have a lot of flesh, and the flesh tends to be very bitter. They're not really good for eating. But gourds have been used historically because they dry much better than squash. And so you can actually make vases out of them. You can make bottles.
And decorations
as well.
You can also, if you run over all of them, they're all squashes.
Yes!
Squash on your cheek.
Yeah, I got some squash all over. But this winter, all through the fall and winter, you're going to be confronted with a wide variety of squash at the grocery store. And I want to help you understand the clutter in front of you because they all have slightly different qualities. So let's start with what I would call your workhorse of a squash. This is called the acorn squash. And everyone here is familiar with an acorn squash.
Yeah. Really?
So these are great. They're great for single serving. You can cut them right in half and roast them. They're sweet. They're fibrous. They're delicious. Moving on, then we have the kabocha right here. The kabocha is really interesting. Kabocha actually means squash in Japanese, and it is a Japanese varietal of a squash. They tend to be yellow inside, and they cook up a little bit drier. So you want to use great for stuffing. Moving on, I would say the king of squash, which everybody knows, is the butternut. Right? The butternut, bright orange inside, very sweet, very tender when it's roasted. This is what you make soups out of. This is what you roast, it's in everything. Yum. But my favorite squash of all kind is actually the kind you're eating right there, which is called the delicata squash.
The kind we ate.
The kind you ate. You already finished.
This is delicious.
A delicata squash is so called because when you roast it, the skin is so thin, it's so delicate, you actually can eat the skin. You don't have to peel it at all. Now, if you notice, actually, it's unpeeled. Yeah, you can see the green stripes. The delicata squash is yellow inside, and it's very sweet. It is unbelievably delicious. Of course, does anyone know why we actually carve pumpkins this time of year?
Because we're bored.
So traditionally at the end of October, that's when the veil between the spirit world and the real world was thin enough that spirits could cross over. Good spirits and bad spirits both arrived, and in order to ward off the bad spirits who were here to take us back with them, we would carve out pumpkins and put a lantern in them because evil spirits are easily scared.
Yeah.
Interesting.
I just asked God, he takes care of it.
All right. Spaghetti squash we've got right here.
That's my favorite squash.
Why is it your favorite squash?
Because, you know what, you can use it instead of pasta and make spaghetti bolognese with spaghetti squash. Yeah. I do it often.
And her hair looks like spaghetti.
Does it?
It does.
Yeah. With marinara on it. Wonderful. Hubbard squash.
Hubbard squash is this monster right here in the middle. So Hubbard squash is actually, this is what would have been cultivated 9,000 years ago. This is the sort of thing that we would have seen in early America in the Southwest. They have huge, I mean, it's very thick. They are really meaty, and they have very very oily, fatty seeds. And these store for months on end.
Really? Are those what they had at the first Thanksgiving, maybe?
Oh,
I don't know. Christina's.
Wow! Whoa! Whoa! Wow! I don't even have a comeback for that.
She made an amazing dinner.
She surely did. Those pilgrims, she's got them on speed dial. Let me tell you. If you have more information from Dan, you can go to renegadekitchen.com. Don't be mad at me.
Well,
wait, I do have a heart. I know it's in there somewhere.
Somewhere.
All right.
Well, all right. We're going to go take care of this. Hairstylist to the stars, Kristoff, will be teaching us some last-minute Halloween hair tricks to complete your costume.